story is about a mine disaster that happened in Idaho in 1971, in which 91 miners lost their lives in the under an hour, and the repercussions that has on a small town, small mining town in Idaho. It's told through three central characters, one of whom is the brother and son of a miner, one of whom is the wife of a miner, one of whom is a miner, and not all of the people survive to the end of the story, but it's just a way of talking about how a little bit of, or a great deal of tragedy can cause reverberations in a town like this. I knew something about it. I'd moved to Montana to go to college in 72, and the summer of 73 I was working on the railroad in a small town in Idaho not far from this place, and so I knew people who were in the community that were affected by it. And it was famously, like, after the disaster there was so much misbehavior and so much chaos and so much sorrow and so much people were freaking out that it just seemed interesting, and I felt like I knew enough to write about it. You know, like, I knew what these guys sounded like when they were cursing, and I knew what they did on the weekends, and I knew what they, you know, how much, what they, just what the cars looked like. And so in some ways it's not so much history as personal history. It's something that I, you know, wrote out of my own memory as much as I did out of the public memory of the event. This is an angry book in a lot of ways. One of the characters, my favorite character, is the widow, a miner, is a deeply angry person, is sort of like consumed by the fires of her own anger. But that's just one of a range of responses to this. I mean, I think there's a political anger that underlies the whole book that I never talk about explicitly, but there is something about the fact that these miners were killed and the mine continued operations 6 months later, you know, with complete indifference to the environment around there, to the lives of the families of these miners that were killed. I mean, they got their last paychecks and that was it. So I think there is something that, to me, seems really unjust and really, my way of responding that is not to, you know, pound on the table and use big words, just to try to present these lives as accurately as I can. It was a political book for me to write, but there's no politics in the book. You know, it's like, for me, it's the political stuff is just to try to make these lives visible, to try to make these situations visible. I mean, you see the corporation, you see the miners, you see the you know, but how these people are treated. So for me, I felt that was that. There, but nobody in the book is political. Nobody even thinks of themselves as being politically located in any particular place.